current president, Harrow residents, the pledge the young people who are here today, let's join together to say our condolences to the family. Our sincere thoughts, prayers are with all the family, friends, and everyone that has been affected by this horrific tragedy. Please accept Brent thoughts and prayers at this sad time. I would also like to say that Fryent Country Park is well loved by the Brent community, and we should not step away from it at this time. Instead, we should honor the memory of Nicole and Bibaa by reclaiming this park. We will continue to remember them. Thank you, Bishop.
Thank you. Right, now I invite Barry Gardner, MP for Brent North, to say a few words.
Pete and Natasha, thank you so much for organising today. Mr. Mayor, thank you for what you've said. Many of us here love this place. We love it. Some of us walk dogs here. Some of us just love to come into the countryside. Some of us have been working here for many, many years, tending this place. And I think the horror with which we have felt that this place has been defiled by what has happened is the reason that so many people are here today. But this place is not defiled. It is two full, loving lives that have been defiled. It is a family that has been defiled. It is our community that has been defined. And we are here as an expression of solidarity with Nicole and Bibaa's family, and as an expression of solidarity for our whole community. Because we recognize evil when it strikes us, and we say that we stand against it. This is an ancient place. That's one of the reasons why we love it so much. It has a history. And that is why we must carry it forward as a place at the center of our community, as a place not of negativity, but as a place that gives rest and peace and succor to all of us. So thank you for being here. Thank you for the expression of solidarity that you're giving, not just to the family, but to each other and to our community.
Our beautiful and talented daughters gone. Although there was a large age gap between them, they shared a lot of the same interests. They were both very much interested in the arts. Bibaa was a hard-working professional and an exceptional senior social worker, a passionate advocate for safeguarding children and vulnerable families. Before qualifying and to earn some extra cash, she would transport disabled children to their activities. At her side, in a car seat, she would have had our granddaughter, who was only a couple of months old. Her passengers loved them both. She knew all their names, and Bibaa would have them singing as they drove along. Bibaa loved her family, and she was proud of her parents' gifts and talents. Bibaa's father, Herman, having been a former ABA featherweight champion and businessman, setting up his own building and contracting company. As her mother, she admired my moving from office agency work to training to be a teacher, and then later to train for the priesthood. Bibaa was just barely 5 foot, but she had the heart of a lion and a smile that would put the Blackpool illuminations to shame. Nicole, being the youngest of three sisters, was a joy from the moment she entered this world. Nicole saw beauty in everything. She had a very calm and positive attitude towards most things in life. She was a strong advocate for humanitarian causes and saving our planet. Her father, Christopher, and I would laugh together, agreeing that Nicole was a child of the 60s. She was an amazing photographer, actor, and singer. Her speaking voice was silky smooth. Her voice teacher at school had said she should do radio or TV presenting. Friends and family all agreed that she was beautiful inside and out. Nicole was incredibly laid back and very approachable. Untimely deaths, we will spend the rest of our lives trying to come to terms with. The tributes for our girls keep flooding in. It has been comforting, heartbreaking, and at times overwhelming. Faith and prayer are keeping us going. I'm not sure how we'd get through this without it. The bond that links your true family is not one of blood, but of respect and joy in each other's lives. Richard Farr.
Brent in 1984 combined Barnhill and Fryent Way and made this place Fryent Country Park. This much-loved place has, as the MP was saying, been violated by the act that took place here. But it belongs to the people of Brent, the people of Northwest London. Mina Smallman, the mother of the sisters, expressed the desire very clearly that we should, in this act of commemoration, give the park back to the people. So I'm going to say some words now, which are prayers, but if you're not a praying time, please join in with what the sentiment expresses. Blessed are you, Lord God, creator of the universe, for you have given us this park with its many gifts, sunshine and flowers, butterflies and trees, fresh air and sunshine. Thank you for these gifts, for those who tend this park, for all who've enjoyed good times here. By the cleansing fire of your Holy Spirit, purge and heal this place of every spirit of fear and despair that clings to it from past terrors. Transform this history into inspiration for justice, freedom, and peace. May this park once again be a place of celebration, refreshment, and love. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.